So this summer, on a really hot day, I decided to make Kool-Aid because my 5-year-old asked me to. Now, the problem with my 5-year-old is this kid really likes his sugar. And he really likes his Kool-Aid too. And if you've ever made Kool-Aid before, you take some water, you dump way too much sugar in, you add the flavoring packet, mix it all up, and voila, you have Kool-Aid. Well, anyways, this time my son decided he was gonna watch me make the Kool-Aid. So got everything out, got the water, poured in the Kool-Aid. Poured in the sugar and then started to mix it up. And as I'm mixing it up, he's getting more and more worried until finally he looks at me and he's like, "Where's the sugar? What did you do with the sugar?" Because he looked at it and all of a sudden that the sugar was gone. Okay? And it was really interesting trying to explain to him that the sugar's still there, it's just dissolved. So that made me think of a little science experiment that we can do. Because we know that whenever you take a solid like sugar and dissolve it in water, it kind of like goes away or disappears. But what's happened to the mass? Okay, has the mass disappeared too for that sugar? So what I want to do in this activity is we want to determine the total mass of a system when like sugar dissolves in water. So your job is going to be to compare the mass of that water and sugar system before and after it dissolves in the water. So here's what you're going to need. You're going to need one of these little triple beam balances. You are going to need a little cup. You are going to need a plastic bag. You're gonna need one of these little sugar cubes, and then you're gonna need some water. All right. So the idea is we want to find the mass of this system of everything combined, and we want to do it before we dissolve the sugar in water and after we do that. It's gonna be really important that you record your findings and be able to defend your results once you've done that all. So let's kind of go through this step by step. So the very first thing you're going to do is on your triple beam balance, first thing you're going to want to find the mass of the cup and record that. And it needs to be an empty cup. Okay, then go and find the mass of the empty bag, record that. Next, you need to take your cup, fill it about two-thirds of the way with water. Now be careful because the sink, it sprays all over the place. But anyways, find the mass of the water and the cup and then record that as well. Now, here's where we have to be really careful because we want to make sure that we're recording the mass of the water and the sugar and not getting anything going in or anything going out. So what I want you to do there is take your little sugar cube, put that in there, and then just find the mass of both the bag and the sugar together. Now you're going to need to go and pour the water into the bag. Close it really tightly. You got to make sure that everything is all closed, or else you're going to have a big mess. Okay? And then it's going to take a little while, and you're going to have to kind of help it dissolve without poking a hole in the bag. So that would be kind of sort of important there. So you'll kind of mess with that for a little while. But once it's all dissolved, what we need to do is find the mass of the total system. So you're going to take the bag, you're going to take the water that's inside the bag, the sugar that's dissolved, you're going to put that in the cup and find the mass of everything together. And what I want you to do with that is then be able to tell me, okay, what was the mass of the water and the sugar before? And what was the mass of the water and the sugar after? Really interested to see what you find.